President Trump distancing himself from his personal attorney, Michael Cohen, while admitting for the first time that Cohen represents him in what he calls the crazy Stormy Daniels deal. White House doctor Ronny Jackson withdrawing his nomination to head the VA in the wake of multiple allegations of drinking on duty, mishandling prescription meds, and having a hostile workplace environment. And the president's unhinged interview that sources tell CNN had White House aides wincing in response. But all of this is against the backdrop of an administration that has been, let's say, truth challenged from the very beginning.
This was the largest audience to ever witness an inauguration, period.
Well, that's a lie, period. You think they would have learned by now, but people on Team Trump just keep getting caught in their own lies. They think they can lie and get away with it. And why? Why wouldn't they? After all, the president does. Remember those controversial big raises for two EPA employees, raises the White House opposed? Well, here's what EPA boss Scott Pruitt told Fox News about that last week.
I did not know that they got the pay raises until yesterday.
Okay, and here's what he told Congress today, completely changing his story, that he didn't know about the raises.
I was not aware of the amount, nor was I aware that of the bypassing or the PPO process not being respected.
So see what just happened there? A cabinet-level secretary admitting he did know something about those raises after telling the press he didn't. And they call us fake news somehow. And of course, there's White House Press Secretary Sarah Sanders, bobbing and weaving pretty much every day from the press room podium. Let's listen to what she said yesterday about the president's admission, in his own words, that Dr. Ronny Jackson didn't have the experience to run the VA.
Yesterday, the president suggested that Dr. Jackson does not have the experience to run the Department of Veterans Affairs. Is that a fair assessment? That he lacks that experience?
That's not what the president said. I think you're taking some of his words out of context.
But in fact, that's exactly what the president said. Listen.
I know there's an experience problem because lack of experience, but there's an experience problem. The Veterans Administration is very important to me.
So, and the mistruths appear to be contagious, even extending to some of the president's boosters, like Trump supporters Diamond and Silk, a.k.a. Lynette Hardaway and Rochelle Richardson. They insisted to Congress today that they were never paid by the Trump campaign, even though documents the Trump campaign itself filed with the FEC show they were paid $1,274.94 back in November of 2016 for field consulting.
Ms. Hardaway, I think you stated on the record today at least three times, quote, we were not paid by the Trump campaign. Is that correct?
That is correct.
Okay. You have an FEC document that clearly indicates that the two of you were paid for field consulting by the Trump campaign. That's just one document. There may be others that are out here. And presumably, this was a document filed with genuineness and authenticity by the campaign of the president that you so love. Mm-hmm. And so I'm just trying to figure out.
We understand
who
that this was
is fine. Lying here.
And that's the thing about this truth challenge administration. It all starts at the very top with a president who says whatever he wants, whenever he wants. Listen to what he told Fox News today about his fixer and longtime personal attorney, Michael Cohen.
Well, as a percentage of my overall legal work, a tiny, tiny little fraction. But Michael would represent me and represent me on some things.
And just like that, the president gave the feds ammunition to argue that the documents seized in that FBI raid on Cohen are unlikely to contain a lot of privileged material, even though Cohen's attorney had argued exactly that. But the president wasn't done, not by a long shot. He actually admitted today for the first time that Michael Cohen represented him in the Stormy Daniels case.
He represents me like with this crazy Stormy Daniels deal. He represented me.
It was just 3 weeks ago, that President Trump himself told reporters on Air Force One he knew nothing about the $130,000 hush money payment to Daniels, one made by Cohen, and said he knew nothing about the case.
President, did you know about the $130,000 payment to Stormy Daniels? Then why did Michael Cohen make it if there was no truth or allegation?
Well, you have to ask Michael Cohen. Michael's my
Again, this is a president who will say whatever he wants, whenever he wants. And the question is, who do you believe? And for those who believe it, why do you believe it?
Why?
I want to bring in now CNN Politics executive or editor at large, Chris Saliz. I do that to you every time, Chris.
It's fine.
And giving you a promotion. And CNN political analyst Ryan Lizza and April Ryan and CNN counterterrorism analyst Phil Mudd. Good evening to all of you. Thank you for joining us this evening. So I laid it out. Why do they lie so much, Phil? The president and this administration.
What's the cost? What's the cost? You go through the initial electoral process and the president says the former president, President Obama, was not born here. Wins the election, eventually acknowledges before the election, obviously, that maybe that claim about the birth certificate wasn't true. He wins
with no apology.
Election. That's correct. My point is the only bottom line here is not the truth. The bottom line is when you have investigators led by Robert Mueller who have to determine whether your violations of the truth are actually federal legal violations, then we'll hold you accountable. The accountability here is not the truth. It's whether it violates the law.
Okay,
that's the bottom line.
That is the bottom line. But so, you know, it started with the whole birther thing, which was not true, which was a lie. And then, Chris, I mean, we could go. I mentioned it a little bit. Go back to the beginning of this administration when Sean Spicer stood at that podium and lied about inauguration crowd sizes. It's something that started on inauguration day, day one, isn't it?
Yes. And in fact, during the campaign, I mean, this is just someone who is not, he has a very casual relationship with the truth. Donald Trump believes the truth is what he believes the truth to be. He believes you are entitled to your own truth. You know that old saying, you're entitled to your own opinions, not your own facts. Donald Trump believes he's entitled to his own facts. He told more than 2,000 either outright lies or distortions, according to the Washington Post, within the first year of his administration. What's difficult here is people say, well, what's the penalty? Well, in the near-term politics, at least for his base, there isn't a huge penalty. I would argue, however, that there is a long, medium to long-term erosion in our ability to agree on a set of sort of parameters, the rules of the game. We don't necessarily have to agree which team we're rooting for, but we agree that the game will, let's say, it's going to go four quarters, it's going to be 12 minutes in each quarter. You can't tackle anyone because that's called a foul. If we can't agree on that, then the game can't be played. That's what worries me. Sure, it hasn't hurt him yet. That doesn't mean it is not detrimental in the medium to long term for democracy, because I think it is.
Yeah. Brian Pruitt, you know, told Fox News that he didn't know about the pay raises. Today he seemed to contradict himself. Does Pruitt's changing story even matter to this administration?
No, because the tone is set at the top. And when you have a president that lies about small things and lies about big things and lies about things that are right in front of his face and lies about pretty much anything he thinks he can get away with, that tone is set at the top, and we see the effect it has. It filters down through the press secretary, Sean Spicer, on the first day, who sets the tone for the administration by lying about a small thing, sets the tone for administration officials to lie to journalists. Anyone that covers this White House knows that White House officials lie routinely to White House reporters covering the place. You know, previously, aides in White House in the Bush administration, the Obama administration, they lie. They would misdirect, not tell the truth. But the way the sort of breadth of the lying and deceiving that comes from this administration is not like anything in the modern era with respect to a White House. And I think Phil and Chris, you know, hit the right questions. What's the penalty? What are the costs? And, you know, there are, in our democracy, when bad stuff happens, when an administration is acting badly and lying at the top is bad, I think we can all agree on that. It's our job in the press to call it out, to speak honestly about what's going on and do it every day without partisanship and without becoming numb to what's going on.
Without fear or favor, as it says.
Absolutely. But it's the voters' job to decide if they've had enough, right? And it's Congress's job to decide if they'll tolerate it. And right now, people have a party that protects him.
I know, but I actually think people have had enough. I actually think that it's, as you said, it's a party that protects us. The people in Washington, the congressmen and the senators on the Republican side who are not saying anything, and the minority of people in the country who are sort of sycophants, and they will, it doesn't matter to them. They know he's lying, but it doesn't matter to them. And so, but Ryan, you mentioned
there's a means justify the ends attitude in the Republican Party right now, and until that breaks, I don't think we'll get a lot of change.
Well, history is going to be a very severe judge of that. I trust me.
I didn't mean to interrupt you, Don.
But no, that's all right. But it will. April, Ryan just mentioned the people who cover the White House every day. You cover the White House every day, and sometimes I watch the press briefings, and you guys are a lot nicer than I would be. And I wonder how you sit there every day and you can be so respectful when someone cuts you off, someone makes faces at you, they're rude to you, you know that they're lying to you straight to your face. So, but it's not just that; it is the sheer volume of lies. That's the problem. Why do they get away with it?
They get away with it for the moment. People are taking note. And the great thing about it is we have film, we have audio that we can roll back. And unfortunately, they get caught in a lot of this shading of facts or changing facts. And you started out with Sean Spicer. And that first day, the day after inauguration, where size did matter. You know, they were very upset about the inauguration crowd size being so thin. And then the next day, the women just started walking around. They dwarfed the crowd size from inauguration day. So what they like to do, if it's not in their favor, and you can see this as clearly as a freshly washed window, Don, and that's why you don't get upset, because the facts are there. Mm-hmm. When it does not bode well for them, they spin. Mm-hmm. And I really hope that it's not a lie, because I remember some of the press secretaries from previous administrations. They made it clear they did not want to get out there and lie, because it's on the record and it makes them look bad. But the question is, how far do you go down this road? Because they've gone pretty far and they can't pull it back. And one of the panelists said, you know, what does this do to the democracy? Because the next person that runs for president is watching. How far can they go? What can they get away with? Because each time a president pushes the ball or kicks the can down the road, whatever, or pushes the envelope forward, they move it a step forward for the next president to do something similar. And the question is, how do you stop it? And we are there as the fourth estate and the first line of questioning of an American president and the press secretary. But all we can do is ask the questions, and the American people, with the transparency, see it for themselves.
Yep.